This is Hyfindr Expo highlights from the Hydrogen Expo in Houston 2024. I'm pleased to welcome Erwin Bosma of CleanH2. Erwin, what innovations are you guys presenting at the show?
Hi there. The innovation that we're bringing the Enaptor AEM technology from Germany into the US market. CleanH2 is headquartered in Centennial, which is in the Denver district, the tech district. So yeah, we're a Colorado-based company. And we're bringing the technology in and we're making it available for the US markets with all kinds of services as well. So we work with integrators, we work with all kinds of solution providers. We bring all these different components that you need to produce hydrogen, because the electrolyzer is a core component of it,
yes,
but it's not the only component, obviously.
Okay. So Enaptor AEM technology, so those are Enaptor electrolyzers.
Electrolyzers from engine and membrane exchange, so
yes,
that's the technology that they bring.
Okay,
yeah.
And so you bring it to the US market. So why should customers care about this? What's in it for them?
Well, what is unique about the Enaptor electrolyzers, which you can see,
yeah,
we have smaller units that produce about a kilogram a day.
Okay, so
every one of this is an electrolyzer. We have a dryer and a water tank.
Yes.
So you have a complete solution there that can bring that together. And you can stack that, so you can go from, this is 5 kilograms, you can go all the way to 20 kilograms. So that's already unique. But then you can go much bigger as well, because these cores that are in there can also be used in multi-core solutions.
Okay.
And the multi-core solution, we show here the 1 megawatt,
yes,
that produces 453 kilograms in a day. So you can really scale the solutions. You can go from 1 kilogram all the way up to 453. This is a standard container, 40 feet. And then you can even go further than that, because you can stack multiple of those containers on your property as well.
So is this a project that you guys have done already? Is this in the US, this unit?
So Enaptor itself has, yeah, already shipped more than 5,000 of these single core electrolyzers,
yes, yes, yes,
to a large variety of different countries.
Yeah, I understand they built a big factory just for them. Yeah.
They did, exactly.
Much
right.
Much like a giga kind of factory.
Exactly, yeah, right. It's a good size.
Yeah.
And now we've actually, in the US, in the first 6 months that we're here, we already sold two of the larger systems, and we have a lot of interest in anywhere from 120 kilowatt all the way up to 1 megawatt, and then we have a couple of projects that are multi-megawatt.
Multi-megawatt. So this container will be 1 megawatt, something like
this?
That?
This is a 40-foot container, which is 1 megawatt.
And then multi-megawatt will be several of them.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Can you just go back to the other one? So
yeah,
this means that these are actually the single units, and they can be, is it correct that they can be more or less infinitely combined?
Can.
You just keep scaling that.
That's exactly right. And the nice thing of having smaller units, mm-hmm, it works really, really well with renewable energy like solar and wind.
Okay.
So the biggest challenge that electrolyzers have, if,
yeah,
you have a very low energy,
yes,
input coming in, right, to start it up,
yeah,
they can't produce hydrogen right away.
Okay.
But because we can start at 3% of the available input power, we have a much larger curve to produce,
okay,
hydrogen.
And how do you do that? Do you do that by running the hydrogen through each one and then just at a lower level, or you switch them on block by block?
It's block by block. So the software is very, very intelligent. It knows when to switch on a block. We call them strings.
Yes.
The string is 10 different cores together.
Yeah, yeah.
And yeah, that's how that.
So do you provide that software as well?
That comes with it, yeah. We call that the EMS,
yeah,
the energy management solution.
Yeah.
And the energy management solution is not just for the Enaptor products, because that's also what we see here in the US, right? They say, is it just Enaptor? No. If you have a water purification part of it, that can be integrated.
Okay, okay.
Pumps, storage, and then fuel cells, all those applications around it can all be integrated into the Enaptor EMS.
Okay, can you show the other container again? So,
yeah.
So what this needs is obviously water.
It needs purified,
yeah,
water.
Purified water, okay.
Yep.
So what we need, a purified or some kind of water source for this?
Yeah.
This reason at the top is
chillers.
It's cooling.
Cooling.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
now it has electrolyte inside. It has the pumps for that.
Okay. And then storage. So do you provide all of this?
So
the purifying to the storage to the cooling.
So we provide the actual electrolyzer.
Yes.
But then we work very closely. So we've already worked with a variety of different integrators, and we make sure they have the experience to go and help our customers.
Okay.
So while we were here in Houston, we've actually worked with a pneumatic and hydraulic company, P&H.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
And
yes,
they're one of our partners, and they're actually going. They're also now a service partner of ours. So we trained them while they were here,
all right,
so they can go out and service them. So all service and maintenance is now also in the US.
All right, okay, so this can work. Just one more thing that occurred to me, in the US sometimes they have different regulations and so on, and you know, if they're coming from Germany, what about that? Anything to consider?
Absolutely, so one of the first things we made sure of, that all the components that come in are all UL certified.
Yeah, okay.
And that's a real big one, right? Okay. And then we also work with our integrators and their end customers to make sure that local regulations are also met.
All right.
The nice thing is the production standard is very, very high. So we have not encountered a single instance where we did not qualify.
All right, okay. So, okay, well, with that, what would be your outlook in terms of, I mean, you say you have two systems that you're already putting in.
So we have a really good pipeline right now. So we actually made it public that in the first 6 months, we had very good results. So we're very pleased with that. We have a very robust pipeline for a variety of projects, not just in the 1 megawatt, but we also see a lot of interest in the Flex 120, which is 120 kilowatts, about 50 kilograms a day.
All right, okay.
Because now that this market is ramping, we need prototypes to show that this is real.
Okay.
Right?
Okay,
people don't necessarily want to jump directly into 20 megawatt. They want to start on the smaller systems. Is it real? And then scale. And there we see we have a very large pipeline for those.
For that. Okay. Well, that sounds really good. And actually, for me, that sounds really great that we're going to have many locations in the U.S.
Yes.
With hydrogen available.
Yes.
Which generally helps the technology. So thank you for sharing this, and I wish you good luck in bringing this technology even more to the US. I think it's the most important market for the hydrogen world, and something that we can all learn from. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, and thanks for watching.